Hi, in this tutorial, we're going to look at bit manipulation using the Java Integer class. Bit manipulation is used in error correction, compression, encryption, and optimization algorithms. It's one of those things that's really important, or you're not going to see it at all, but it's really important. There are many operators we use to manipulate bits, but as we saw in the previous Integer class tutorials, they don't work for instances. The operators are meant for primitives. To fix this, Java provides several methods for manipulating bits in the Integer class. Let's take a quick look at all the methods available. The first one is bit count. At first, we might think this tells us the number of bits in an integer, but it's really a count of the set bits. That means all the ones. So for this number, the bit count is 2. That's because the first and last bit are set, and the rest are cleared. When we're counting bits, it can be useful to know the highest bit set. For example, if you're looking for all the set bits, knowing the highest bit set can reduce the number of tests. The highest bit set is the furthest bit to the left. So back to our number, 10001, the highest value is 16. This is because the 16th place has the set bit. The method is called highest one bit. We can get the lowest bit as well. This method is called lowest one bit. Using the same number, we'd get an answer 1. That's because the leftmost bit is in the ones place. To get the number of leading zeros, we'd call it number of leading zeros. This will tell us how many zeros in the binary number our integer starts with. So 2,009,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, the first bit is a signed bit, so it doesn't count. The next three are zeros, so this method returns the number 3. We can also get the number of trailing zeros using the method number of trailing zeros. Again, this only works for signed numbers. Using our number from earlier, the answer returned is 0. That's because the number doesn't end with any zeros. We can reverse the bits in an integer using the method called reverse. This method reverses the bits but returns an int. This method reverses all the bits in a 32-bit number. So in this example, even though 3 only has 2 digits, all of the zeros are reversed as well. If we print it as is, we just get the number reverse number holds. We need to convert it to a binary string like this to see the binary digits. We can also reverse the bytes in an integer using the method reverse bytes. We might use this method when reading bytes stored in a different order than what Java uses. This method also returns an int. What this method does is reverse our int in a byte at a time, not a bit. So when we reverse this number's bytes, it looks like this. I'm printing it out in hex because it's easier to see the reversal. If you remember, we could shift bits left and right using the operators shift right and shift left. These operators are also available in the integer class. The methods are rotate right and rotate left. Let's start with the number 3. In binary, it looks like this. If we pad the missing zeros for the full integer, it looks like this. When we rotate left by 2 positions, the ones move left. When we rotate the same number to the right by 2 positions, we get a big negative number. The reason is the leftmost bit gets the rightmost bit. You can think of it as circular. Since the first bit is 1 now, the number becomes negative. If we want to know the sign of a number, we can call the method signum. This returns negative 1 for negative numbers and 0 for 0 and 1 for positive numbers. Floats also have a few bit twiddling methods. If we want to create a representation of our float according to the IEEE 754 floating point bit layout, we can call the method float_to_int_bits. This gives us the integer representation of the float as an int. This is great for learning how numbers are stored internally.
And that's all we'll cover for the number class methods. If you have any questions, add them to the comments below. We are done with the number class and we're moving on to Java String class next. If you enjoyed the video, please share and like. If you also want to sign up for the DJU's newsletter, that's a monthly email containing this month's videos, plus tips and news not in the videos. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.